Hey guys, just got in and I have about 20 minutes before I go to my next session, which is at Whole Foods. I'm coming from running groups in Malibu, and we were talking about, I know it sounds so LA, groups in Malibu and sessions at Whole Foods. Whatever it takes, my friends. But we're talking about pain versus suffering, and I know you've probably heard this before, but I wanted to remind you, and I'm also going to eat while we talk, or while I talk. Speaking of eating, nutrition seminar for members, January 1st, Google Hangouts, member Kelly is a nutritionist, and she is generous enough to donate her time to do a Q&A and talk about nutrition as we start, kick off Get Fit Done, which I think everyone should participate in. It's New Year, and we're going to use the community to make each other accountable. And I'm also going to do it too because I'm eating microwaved Brussels sprouts as I speak. And can I show you what I'm eating? Microwaved Brussels sprouts, pork chops with canned applesauce, and some weird sausage meat protein. It's better than fast food, right? Okay, so the difference between pain and suffering. Pain is mandatory. Pain promotes growth. You will go through pain for the rest of your life. There's gonna be moments when, whether it's physical or emotional or mental, there is always pain, and pain is actually a good thing, okay? The difference between pain and suffering is not mandatory. Suffering is optional. And I know you've heard that before. There's truth to that. And what they mean by that is that they say suffering is a choice, which I kind of have a problem with. I don't like the word choice because it's like a light switch and it's not. I think that it starts with a choice. Not everyone has to suffer. And the difference between pain and suffering is power. When someone feels powerless is when they start suffering, okay? So if you're an addict and you are powerless over your addiction, you are now suffering. When you get that power back, then it's painful, but there's less suffering. What is this? What is going on with this? Helmet hair, ladies and gentlemen. So, pain and suffering. I lost my train of thought. Pain creates a hole, and you have to decide. The choice is what you want to fill that with. If you fill it with anger, resentment, you become powerless. And as you lose your power, then you begin to suffer, right? When pain creates a hole, right, if you're going through a breakup or whatever it is that is painful in your life, and if you feel that with love and gratitude, you start taking the power back, okay, forgiveness. And by feeling more empowered, then you don't suffer. The only difference between suffering and pain is the amount of power that we have. So when people feel powerless, they are suffering. When people feel powerful, they know that it's pain, and it doesn't minimize the pain, but they're not suffering. So, happy Thursday, guys. That is my rant as I transition from lunch to another session. I'll see you guys in the nutrition seminar that's happening Thursday. Is it Thursday? I'm not sure. It's happening Tuesday, January 1st. First day of the year, 2013. Okay, be well. I'm adding this footage because I know you guys want to listen to that song. I gotta go. Look at this. I gotta go. you guys listen to the song. Enjoy it. Don't lie. You know you love it. You know you love it.
song for the broken hearted.